live program that I started early on in the pandemic, where we talk all things design, color, and trend. And I always have a wonderful guest who joins me. Last time I tried to interview this phenomenal person, I said to him, you know, I think that it was God in the universe that just is in charge of everything, because his Wi-Fi wasn't working well. It was in the very early on stages of the Black Lives Matter protests. And he and I couldn't get our internet connection to work, so we did not end up chatting with my dear friend David Santiago at that point. But instead, I was able to reflect on what was happening in the world at the time and trust in the universe that there was a reason that he was supposed to join us at a different day. So here is round two. My good friend David Santiago, many of you know him as Strictly Santi. He is an amazingly talented interior designer. He's also a fabulous product designer. He has some great collections of wall covering, of lighting, all different things that he's consulting on. The man is constantly in motion, but he is also one of the most generous souls and generous spirits that I have had the honor of getting to know in this industry. So the design industry, which is where I'm seeing many of your names and faces, I feel truly blessed to be part of this community of people, because design really is all about giving of yourself. That's why we do it. It's a service business. It's sharing our creativity. It's sharing our passion. It's sharing our love. And we do what we do every day to make a difference for the people who live in the spaces and interact with the products that we put out into the world and the universe. So I know that for sure that the design industry is a loving, giving, phenomenal industry I am blessed to be part of. And I'm excited tonight to welcome David Santiago onto the show. So let me see if I can connect with him now. Facebook, here he is, we made it!
Oh my God.
Take a deep breath. You handsome devil, you. Oh my goodness. The haircut is everything.
Thank you, dear. Thank you.
Yes,
so much.
Now.
I just want to make sure
I can hear you. Okay, you're getting yays from Howard Elliott. We're getting loves and hearts. All right, guys, just take it in, because the voice is amazing. This man is a singer, but look at the face and the hair. So he's had long hair. I know. Listen, I'm a Jewish mother, so I'm just gonna go on. All right. He had like long, glorious locks, and then the next thing you know, he posts on Facebook like the whole situation. And we were talking about what a generous spirit you are, and I know that you chose. You said for the second time to donate your hair, correct?
Yes. I've been growing it for 2 years now, and it was just getting to that time, and I just decided now I want to go, and I'm going to go the full gamut. And we did 4 braids of 15 inches long, total of 60 inches worth of hair, and 2 year growth for wigs for kids.
That's amazing. It's unbelievable. Oh, no. Well, good for you. That's just incredibly beautiful that you did that. You looked gorgeous with long hair. I'm obsessed, though, when I saw the pictures, and it's like even better. I feel like in semi-person right now. Just love the spike. It's, first of all, I mean, I'm sure you've heard it, but I wish that's all I had to do was like cut my hair, and you look like a whole new person. You're like 10 years younger. You look gorgeous. You're welcome.
Thank you. It feels wonderful. You know, I thought I was going to be channeling back, you know, a couple of years back, and it was so liberating and so fresh, and it's so, I needed a change, and it was the right time for me.
Yeah, you wear it well, okay, in good health only, and it's,
Thank you, again, you
rocked both looks. So I was joking, you know, I change my hair all the time, so you're getting love also. Love the hair, you look like a rock star, somebody said. I can't read the names right now, but I see What a Mensch, and David says he wishes he had hair. Me too, David. Mine comes out of a box. All right, let's do this, okay? We're going to talk Design Uncensored. So first of all, L'chaim. Look, we have matching glasses. We have some matching crystal clink. All right, what do you got going in your glass?
Water. I'm very boring today.
Okay, you know what? You'll have a cocktail after. My rosé couldn't come early enough today. I put some fresh berries, frozen berries, to keep it cold. And I'm giving myself a treat right now.
Frozen cherries in my drinks.
That's good. I like it. So talk to me, because, you know, David, as I was saying, is an interior designer. He's got his start doing draperies, so really kind of worked his way up the ranks in this industry. He has made such a name for himself, such an impression on the people, on his clients, on the vendors, on his peers and colleagues who have gotten to know him. He is multi-talented, so not only in the interior design world, but in the product design world, and also, a little known fact, as a trained professional singer, and we talked a little bit about that. But I want to dig in and hear about color, because the way that you see the world, you know, I see the drapes hanging behind you, and I think about you and your brand, and I think color, you know, I think color. Yep. So talk to me about how you utilize it in the interior spaces that you're working on.
I like to infuse energy into spaces with, you know, color, movement, graphic elements. I'm not afraid, you know, I always use the slogan, get Santified. And what that's about, embracing the unfamiliar, the unexpected, what wonderfully makes you nervous. And I love applying color in different facets of design and really taking people from beige to champagne. That's how I do my neutrals. And I love a great polka dot with a great, you know, graphic element behind me and the stripes. You know, a lot of people have nervous tendencies of, you know, stepping outside the box in the comfort, you know, comfort zones of their neutrality. And I just take their hand and I go, let me have your hand. I'm letting it go and embrace the change. Most people are ready for change and they don't know how to embrace it or establish it. And when they hire someone like myself or like you or many designers that utilize color in a very unique way, specific to, you know, their personality, it's so refreshing to see. And it's now more prevalent than ever, at least the past couple of years. You're seeing a lot of color utilized in certain ways.
Absolutely. And I love the idea of get Santified.
Yes. That's it. Basically, embrace the unexpected, you know, take a leap of faith. Not necessarily working with me, but, you know, out of your own comfort zone. And if it ends up that we end up on the same side of the street, bravo, we work together. It's great. And that's what I've been able to do with the lighting collection and the wall coverings collection, and utilizing color to, you know, in with traditional brands, specifically the lighting company.
Yeah.
American Crystal, you know, infusing color to a company that didn't use color.
Let's just talk about that for a minute, because when I saw, I think it was an ad, you know, featuring the product originally, and it launched, probably 2 years ago? How long?
It launched last spring at the Architectural Digest.
Okay, I guess I have no sense of time right now. You know, it's still Thursday for me. When I first saw the ad of this product and just sort of filling everybody in who is not familiar, but American Brass and Crystal, or ABC Lighting, is a company in New Jersey. They do absolutely stunning, very traditional brass and crystal cast chandeliers and sconces and lighting. A term I would use originally was like a little schmaltzy, for those of you who are from the New York area. You know, lots of crystals, dripping with crystals and brass. And you came along, you know, and you use them, and I think you can use things like that through the lens of an interior designer, if you're doing a traditional space or you have a client that really loves glam. But you came along and you took this whole idea and made it so contemporary through the use of color. You gave it irony that is so sophisticated. And I just remember being blown away and saying, wow, what a genius to take it and twist it truly just through the finish and the color, not changing the shapes, not changing the elements, you know, using what they were great at. So talk me through that process. Like, where did that come to you to, you know, how does a brainstorm like that? It was such a simple solution, but so brilliant.
It was really born organically. You know, I utilize them as a resource for a lot of my projects. So we had a sensibility of each other's dynamic.
Right.
And they were working on a project. And I walked by and I literally stopped them like, what is that? And they're like, well, we're trying something new, something in the middle out of our normal collection to compete with, you know, X, Y, and Z. And I said, why are you doing that? I don't come to you for that. I wouldn't come to you for that.
Right.
Put that away. And I was just having fun with them and being sassy. And they were like, well, what would you do? I'm like, well, have you ever thought about color? And that's really how it started. And they're like, no, we don't do color. I'm like, well, you asked.
Yeah.
I said, why don't we look at colors and why don't we, you know, think about how to utilize color, and certainly not with crystal or any of that element. I said, why don't you start with the framework, the solid brass elements of the fixtures of what your brand is about. You're staying on brand. You're not going into an aluminum or a lighter metal or a zinc. You're staying on brand and go raw. We powder coat it and we finish it. And let's go high gloss. And they're like, great. Why don't you get us a color? Why don't you do it for us? I said, sure. And from that simple conversation, or maybe not so simple, it was born. And they're like, look, we don't do color. You do color. You come in here and you do Santi. And I said, okay, I'll find some resources. And from that conversation, it was innocent. I said, I wanted to help my brothers in business.
Yeah.
Think outside. And from there, they're like, you know, this is you. Why don't you do it with us, for us? And voila, a relationship was born by a handshake and then on paper.
Yeah.
And a year later, the American Brass itself, you know, Ross is a wonderful designer and always thinking forward and always open. And that's where we are. We're changing a little bit of the face of American Brass with color and some whimsical draping and changing the shapes of crystals. And like you said, adding a modern flair to what it once was a traditional company.
Right. I love it. How many colors do they make in this line now?
Specifically, I brought 12 colors. And now I'm introducing 4 new colors. Believe it or not, I went a little neutral.
Okay.
I'm introducing a high gloss sandy beige tone, a French light gray, and I'm bringing in like a more sophisticated fuchsia and pink.
Oh, nice.
And we're going back to black and getting to a true navy. And, you know, navies and blacks and neutral sand colors are universal. Everyone will appeal to them. At least the colors will appeal.
Yeah.
Whether they...
I think so. So you're building out your classic palette. Like, you really started with your fashion palette. And then
right.
You're adding your classic colors to that palette. And I
correct.
Love the idea of, like you said, how this relationship started, because for those of you tuning in, I know I've seen some of the names on here. Some of our friends are into licensing already. Some do interior design. Some are other creative types. And there's, you know, some people who are design lovers who are tuning into this. But, you know, you never know where those relationships are going to start or spark. And when you're not afraid to just give an honest opinion in a playful way, or like you said, just help out your brothers in business, you know, you don't know where it could lead, and here it was. It led you to this, you know, great licensing opportunity.
And the same thing happened with Bijou covering Jason and David. You know, we met, we had great chemistry, we started talking. They were in the hospitality and commercial world, and I started talking to them about the concept, the Passport collection, and voila, they're like, why don't we do it together?
Right.
And I said to them, why don't we do it together? And, you know, I finally took that leap, that step forward for myself, being the self-proclaimed prince of wallpaper, into having a collection with, you know, these two young guys in business that are established in another part of the business that was, you know, accessible to me, but not my avenue.
Yeah. For those of you just tuning in, I just want to make sure everybody knows This is strictly Santi. His real name is David Santiago. He is an incredibly talented interior designer, product designer. He's also co-president of IFDA New York, so the International Furnishings and Design Association's New York chapter. Very generous soul and spirit. Recently cut and donated his hair for wigs for kids. And we're talking about his collections of lighting and wallpaper. So talk to me, though. I know you launched the wallpaper in a show house in North Carolina, right? Talk to us about what it's like to do a show house and why do you choose to do something like that? What was the motivation to do a show house?
The timing was really key for me. It was with the Aspire Aspire Home and Design Show House at with the Junior League of High Point. And it was an opportunity for me to marry both brands together, the lighting and the wallpaper, and do, again, the unexpected. It was an arts and crafts style home, and I brought a hospitality coverings, you know, collection to this home. And I thought, how can I play with the space, and how can I utilize, you know, the different levels and elevations of this home with wall coverings and color and lighting. And it was just a perfect fit. It was a great way to market my story, the Passport Collection, you know, wall covering, what I was doing with American Brass and Crystal. And it, for me, I had so much fun. And for those of you that have never done a show house, I think one of the key reasons you do it is for branding, either your company, you know, your interior design firm, or when you're growing and going into branding with brands and collaborations. And then you have other companies that work with the trade and love the trade, like a Howard Elliott, Left Bank Art. Those companies, Aiden Gray, they want to work with designers. And these opportunities, show houses are a caveat in many ways. So I took a step forward and invested in myself, brand, and the companies that I collaborate with.
Yeah, and it is an investment. I mean, you know, you sort of don't know what you're getting yourself into, but you're really doing a full installation there. And, you know, to your point, I think if you can lean into your vendors to support that effort, that always helps and goes a long way in building those relationships on both ends. But it is an investment. It's a marketing dollars and time. Your space in that show house was the staircase, correct?
Right.
How did you approach that? Because I think it was a really unique twist on it. So tell everybody about that. Because you used, here we go, again, talking color, design, trend. You really used color and pattern to make your design speak.
Well, the first thing was the house didn't really have a formal entry. The hallway was kind of like the place where you could make a statement. And a lot of the unexpected things happened. You know, you set out to do this concept, and when you're actually there and things don't necessarily work out, you make wonderful vodka lemonade, and that's what I did.
I love that, right. You know, I was going to say, I thought you were going like, I'm a creative problem solver. You go, no, you just, right. You put a little vodka in your drink.
Exactly. You put a little vodka. Execute it. And, you know, I chose one of the more invigorating colors, yellow, to be the first color you walk into to kind of just give you some energy. And then that cerulean blue on the second elevation to kind of calm you down and prepare for you. The orange that is super, you know, precedes it going up the stairs, and you have this wonderful wraparound staircase. And you're like, wow. And I played with a different direct vertical, horizontal. And it just did so much. For me, it was perfection, if I may say so. I saw everything resolved. And that's a wonderful, gratifying feeling for a designer like myself to venture into where I have and to step back and look at it and go, all right, kid, you got something here. Let's see the journey. Let's begin.
Yeah, and it photographed so beautifully. I mean, I think it just showcased your look, your work, your collections. And I love that you took a chance. Like you said, you sanctified your own space. You know, you pushed, you know, yourself probably out of your comfort zone. And I love that idea in terms of working with an interior designer. Because I know people were on the fence. And of course, there's a lot of people who love design and follow design and sort of aren't sure, you know, maybe they're not sure if they need to hire a professional. And what's your role? Like, what, you know, you see yourself as being that person to push people out of their comfort zone. You know, how do you work? Talk us through your process.
Sure. I'm a man of action at this stage in my life or career. But, you know, if most of my work is by recommendation or I happen to walk into it, I never really advertise. The story of my success is repeat business. And people work with me for because I'm a motivator. I implement designs and I have wonderful resources to get the job done fast. And I work as fast as I talk. Knows me. I either talk this fast, sing this fast, or I'm in the car, which, oops, I think I froze.
But we hear you. Keep going.
Okay. Okay. So,
See, he works fast and he talks fast. Are you back with us? You're back with us. Okay, go ahead. All right. We got you. We're good.
You got me? Okay.
Yes.
So, what my process is, I like a meet and greet with a prospective client, and we get to feel each other out as far as our chemistry dynamic, and also see the task at hand, the concepts, and we're going to be a good match. And I'm not afraid to step back and go, you know, I'm going to recommend you to, you know, Mr. Smith or Mrs. Smith to work instead of me because it may not just be a good fit. And that comes with experience and time. But for me, I do small projects. I do room renovations and refresh and refurbish ideas. And I do full contract new construction projects from flooring, ceilings, and everything in between. I do it all. And I, every job is different. I love consulting jobs. They're really time efficiency point of view. A consultation is great, whether it's on location or a walk on. I like to spend an hour or two, consult, make my recommendations, get my fee, get that check, and you move on. And 9 times out of 10, they call you back and a solidified contract, which for me is confetti. It's potpourri.
David, we love you. Strictly Santi, we love you. Follow this man on Instagram. Follow him on Facebook. You'll find him online. I don't know if it's David Santiago Designs, but he's going to type it in for us right now so that we can all know where to find him. And don't you worry, because we're going to have this on the blog. He and I are going to do a Q&A. I will get all the info and insight. And we'll be posting pictures of his lighting fixtures from American Brass and Crystal, from his...
At Strictly Santi, the Prince of Wallpaper, Tenor Santi.
Oh, the Prince of Wallpaper.
Or Hospidential, Facebook, Twitter. Or call me. Just kidding.
Okay. Perfect. And like I said, just in case you missed him, if he's coming in and out, we will. Okay, strictlysanti.com.